Hello everyone, Alex here from warrantoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can insert information into your MongoDB database. And if you don't have a MongoDB database, then previous videos in this series will show you how to set up a local MongoDB database as well as how to set up a database within the cloud using MongoDB Atlas, which is what I have here. Links to those videos will be in the description. Now before I continue, there's a few different terms you might hear that I want to explain. Those are going to be databases, collections, documents, and schemas. Now, an actual database is probably what you already think it is. It is going to essentially be some type of software or some type of server that is going to take in requests and store information permanently. However, we can't just throw in any information into that database. We have to have a way to organize it. And that's where collections come in. So let's say we want to store users, payments, and messages in some hypothetical application. Again, we can't just throw the information into the database and hope it works. We have to actually organize that data to make it easier for us to read it, both as humans as well as the software. And that's where collections come into play. So collections are a way of organizing specific types of data. And then after that, we have different documents, which is going to be the actual JSON objects or key value pairs. And these are called documents. And so this is how we're going to actually store our data. Now there's a specific way we have to organize our data, and we could do that through something called schemas, which we're going to take a look at in this video. It's essentially an organized way of telling MongoDB how to actually organize the data, and it's going to complain to the programmer, which is us, if the data is trying to be inserted in a way that we do not want. If you take a look in the video description, you will see a GitHub repository where you can clone this simple project. In our main file, we're simply just importing our Mongo utility, which we'll take a look at in a second. And then we're also creating a function called connect to MongoDB, which will essentially use our utility, and then it'll say that we're connected. And then afterwards, whether it throws an error or if everything works fine, because we're using finally, we're then going to close the connection. So if we look inside of our MongoJS file, we see that here I'm importing Mongoose, I'm importing my password from my config file, and then I'm creating a login URL here, and then I'm actually connecting to that URL and then returning my Mongoose object. Now, if you don't know, Mongoose is actually a package that extends the functionality of MongoDB. It makes it easier for us to connect and actually work with the data within MongoDB. Typically within Node.js, whenever you're using Mongo, you are always going to be using Mongoose. There's just no reason not to. So with that said, we can go back to our index file, and we actually need to make a new folder here. So in VS Code, I'm going to click on New Folder, and I'm going to call this Schemas. Now, I'm going to make a new file within this, and this will be called user-schema.js. And inside of here, we're going to define our actual schema, which is going to be the template or the blueprint for how our actual collection should be structured. So to start things off, I'm going to import Mongoose. So constant Mongoose equals require Mongoose. And then I'm going to create a new constant. This will be called user-schema. I'm going to set this equal to mongoose.schema with a capital S. And the first argument is going to be an object. Inside of here is where we actually define what we want our collection to look like. So let's say that we have an email, which will be a string. We can have a username, and which will be a string. And then we can also have a password, which will be a string. Let's keep it simple. We're just going to have these three things. Afterwards, I'm going to export something. So module.exports. And this is going to be associating this schema with an actual collection name. So we can say mongoose.model. And we're going to pass in the first argument. If we see right here, the first argument is going to be the name. This is going to be called users. The second argument is going to be called the schema. And so we can pass in user schema. After that, I can save this file. We can go into my main file here and we can import this. So constant user schema equals require. We have to go into our schemas folder and then import user schema. Then from within here, I'm going to go underneath this console log and I'm going to create some dummy data. So constant user. I'm just going to make some things up. So email will be test@email.com. The username will be Joe. And then the password is going to be password1!! Now that we have this dummy data here, we can actually store this to our schema. So we can say await new user schema. We can pass in our user. We can call .save. This is actually going to insert this user object here into our collection. And so I can save this. And I can go into my console, I can navigate into my folder, and I can run this with node index.js. And we see await is throwing an error. That's because this callback here has to be asynchronous because we're using await inside of it. If I save and restart the server, We then see connected to MongoDB. But if we go back into Google Chrome, and then I click on refresh on the right, we then see a test database and then the user's collection here. And then inside, we see all of our documents. So here we have email, we have username, and we have password. So now I can go back into Visual Studio Code. And let's say I don't include a password. If I comment this line out and I save this, I run this again with Node index.js, we don't get an error at all. So if I go back into Chrome and I click on refresh, we then see we have a second document here that does not have a password. Now let's say we don't actually want that. We want the passwords to always be there. So going back to our schema, we can change the string to an object and we can specify what type we want. We want this to still be a string, but required can be true. And then let's also say we want the other three things, the other two things rather, to be the same. So type is string and required is true. And then finally for email, another object, type is string and required is true. Now we see that we are repeating ourselves, and so we don't want to do that. We want to always make sure that we're not repeating ourselves in our code. So I'm actually going to make a new constant up here called rec string for required string. We're going to simply type the same thing. So type is string, required is true. And then I can actually change these to rec string. So that way we only type that once and we don't actually have to repeat ourselves. And so if we add more things to this that are going to be required strings, we can simply use this constant. So I'm now going to save this, and keep in mind our index file still has our password line commented out. I'm then going to run this with node index.js, and we get an exception here. So if we look at here, it says a validation error, user's validation failed, password is required. And so if I were to uncomment this and save the file, and I were to run this again with node index.js, we no longer get the error. And if I go back into Atlas, I can click on refresh, or if I minimize the console here, there's a find button here. If I click on this, we then see we have a third document with our password again. And so this is how you're going to actually set up a very basic schema and set certain fields to required. Now under type, you can specify number or Boolean or object. And we'll be covering more things about schemas and how to use them within the next few videos in this series.
Thanks for watching this MongoDB tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord, which will be linked in the video description. If you want to learn more about MongoDB, you can consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.